Have you checked your property's assessment? I'm Livingston Parish Assessor Jeff Taylor. 2024 is a reassessment year. From now to the end of August, our staff can help you review your home or business assessment. If you would like to discuss your assessment, please give us a call at 225-686-7278 or come by our office on Government Boulevard in Livingston. We're always here to help you.
Taylor Hubert is a candidate for school board. Remember, Kelly Hennessy was elected to the state legislature, leaving a vacancy. And boy, with the race for president and all the rest, here's one that may be slipping under radar for people.
Yeah, for sure. I'm super excited. From Watson, just about. We moved out there in 2002, came from Central. When my parents had my younger brother, we're almost 7 years apart. They said, we're not going to put two kids through Central Private. So let's drive north. Let's go to Watson, and graduated from there in 2014. Bought my first home in Watson in 2020. But I'm looking forward to it. Trying to reach out to as many people as possible, and within the community and without. Trying to listen to their issues, their concerns, also. And get any sort of opinion I can. I think it's an important race. I'm excited. I'm a little tired. I'm not going to lie. It's an exhausting thing to do.
Well, let's start at the basics. Where is the district?
So the district coming into going north on 16. So you're going to pass up Lockhart, and then there's a little neighborhood. It's called Acadiana Place on the right hand side. It's right past Acadiana Place on Highway 16. You're just going to go, just keep following 16 all the way through, pass up Live Oak Church, and then you're going to go north like you're going towards end of the line, and it's going to cut off right there somewhere between, depends on what part of the parish you're from, it's going to cut off between Weiss or Weiss Road.
So it's pretty much Watson.
It's all of Watson, yeah. So the District 2 map, pretty much.
Are there some local issues in that race? I mean, obviously, Live Oak School, and there's a big construction project at Live Oak Junior High right now.
So say that one more time.
Live Oak Junior High, the gym that they're redoing.
Yes. Yeah. So are there local? You said there's local.
I mean, any local issues?
In Watson, you know, talking to the principals and their staff, the issues they see and the issues they want recovered is technology. They receive some federal money during COVID times. That money's has since dried up. So it's more of a laptop thing. It's the Livingston Parish is a one-to-one parish, so each kid has their own device. So it's getting funding for technology, and you hear a lot of the times, take for instance Live Oak Elementary, it's an older school, I believe it's close to 60 years old. They don't have enough bathrooms. You know, they built the school 60 years ago when the population was much, much smaller than what it is now. So I've heard the phrase multi-purpose buildings, whether that's for a play, whether that's for, you know, hosting community events. But using and building multi-purpose buildings, utilizing that in the community, and then also integrating a bathroom concept, a water fountain concept, a meeting area with some picnic tables. So letting those schools use a multi-purpose building. Now it can get expensive. Obviously, you're throwing in a building with bathrooms and plumbing and technology as well. So I'm excited. I'm eager, and I want to try to be that solution solver.
So the big elephant in the room with Livingston Parish Schools is that employees have, for years now, been trying to get a pay raise. And the one tax proposal that came up to do it didn't succeed. So where does that leave us now?
I would love, if I had that answer, I think I would be the most prized man in Livingston Parish, probably. Where does it leave me? That's something I'm running on. I think we have to figure something out. I think when you drive 45 minutes to Ascension Parish, you drive 40 minutes to Tangipahoa, you go to East Baton Rouge, you're paying for that tax. You know, you're going to eat dinner, you're putting gas in your car around the surrounding parishes, and you're paying that same tax we voted down. Whether we voted it down for whatever reasons is you know, now water under the bridge. Obviously, that's been done and gone. We have to figure something out as a board. I think we have a great superintendent now in Jody Purvis. I think he's got an incredible staff at Central Office that he's assembled and put together. And I think for the most part the board is a good board with the right views aligned. I want to be part of that conversation. I want to be part of that the one that can give an opinion, can help give a solution, and figure out what works for the board, what works for our teachers and our support staff, and what works for our constituents, the taxpayers, ultimately. I'm a taxpayer, but I also am affected because my wife is a teacher in Livingston Parish. She's entering her second year at Southside Elementary. So what can we do? Because I cannot look at a teacher, whether they're a single mom or they're married, I can't look at a teacher and when he or she tells me, I left to go to Ascension because I can now make $12,000 more a year. Or I left to go to Central and I only have to drive 15 minutes across the Amite River and I can make almost $8,000 more a year. I can't blame them. And why would you? At the end of the day, certificates, pat on the backs, and good jobs, they don't pay their mortgage, they don't put gas in their car, and they don't get junior to football and baseball practice. So we have to do something. I'm running because I want to be part of that. I feel like I can impact our community in a positive way, and I feel like we can get something done.
This will be on the November ballot?
November 5th, yes, sir. So on the presidential ballot. So, we always hear about voter turnout being low. I would sure hope not. Voter turnout is not low on November 5th. I think we have a lot at stake on a federal level, and I think every election is important. Everything on the ballot is important. But you'll never hear me criticize early voting. I think I have early voted in almost in every election I voted in. I love early voting. You walk right into the Livingston Parish Library right there on Florida Boulevard. It's very rarely you have to wait in line. You go in, it's very timeless, and then you don't have to go through November 5th, because I remember I did not early vote in the presidential election in 2016. I waited in line for at least 2 hours. So if you can early vote, and I don't have those dates on hand, but if you can early vote, I highly, highly recommend it.
You've been campaigning, and you say you put a lot of shoe leather in this campaign. Are there any issues you heard from the voters that surprised you, stuff you didn't think about?
Not necessarily. It's more of the voters and the constituents needing to trust the school board again, and I think that's going to come over time, right? I mean, you're not gonna win somebody over overnight. You're not gonna win somebody over in the next month, and I think it takes time. I think we've got the right people in place, and I think over the course of the next year or so, with the correct staff and the right board doing the right things by the people, I think that can happen.
What the heck happened that the board appears to have lost some trust in Livingston Parish? Because to the outside, it looks as though you've got a good school system. It's still a good school system. What happened?
We have a great school system. I mean, look, I'm a product of Livingston Parish from third grade on to high school. I want to send my child to Livingston Parish to get a great public education. Watson has the number one public high school in the state of Louisiana. North Live Oak is the top five elementary school in the state of Louisiana. We have a great school system in Watson and in Livingston Parish especially. What happened? I can't answer that. I think there was some hostility for so many months, and whether it's not for a year or so, but I think that's all kind of water under the bridge now, and I think, with the right people in place and we've got the keys in the ignition, we're driving down the road and we're keeping it in between the lines, and we're trying to do right by the people.
So what do you say on the campaign trail makes you the best qualified guy for the job? There is at least another candidate.
There is one more candidate who I've met with, and I have a lot of respect for him. I think what brings me to be the right candidate, I'm young. I'll be 29 in October. I'm energetic. I want to fight, and I want to represent people in the best way I can. I work in this parish. We obviously live in Watson. My wife teaches in this parish. We're invested in Livingston Parish. I am proud to say I'm from Livingston Parish. I'm proud to say I work there. I shop here. We spend our money here.
Is there anything in particular about following in the footsteps of Kelly Hennessy, who's popular in her own right, that you need to fill those shoes? Because she did certain things on the school board I can think of. She didn't shy away from controversial, what you might call cultural issues. She didn't mind being at loggerheads with the administration if that's what it took. Is any of that going to influence your decisions as to what you want to do?
Look, I think when you look at Kelly, who now is now our representative for District 64, I think, and don't hold me to it, and if I'm wrong, Ms. Kelly, I apologize. I think she served 12 years, or right at 12 years, as our school board member. I think Kelly did a great job, okay? I think the citizens of her district, of District 2, I think they trusted her. They looked at her, and they could lean on her. They could call her, and she could get something resolved. She's an instrumental influence in our community. It's big shoes to fill, obviously, but I also want to piggyback on the job Ms. Stacy Robinson has done in the interim. She has stepped in and had an extensive change of leadership. Ms. Stacy, I have a lot of respect for both of those women. So for Stacy to follow the shoes of Kelly, and now for her to come in and they're both very classy ladies. They do it the right way, and they represent Watson the right way. And at the end of the day, if that's how I can follow the footsteps and representing Watson, the Live Oak schools, and our constituents and our voters, if I can do that the right way, at the end of the day, I can lay my head down and go to sleep at night.
What else do you want to tell us?
If anybody has any questions, I'm doing a meet and greet at Casa Maria on August 13th from 6 to 9 p.m. My email, you're more than welcome to follow me on Facebook. My personal email is taylorhubert13@gmail.com. If anybody has any questions, don't hesitate to reach out. I'm trying to be open. I try to get them all answered in a 24-hour time frame. And on November 5th, I want to humbly ask for your vote. And in the meantime, if there's anything I can do for anybody, don't hesitate to reach out.
Have you checked your property's assessment? I'm Livingston Parish Assessor Jeff Taylor. 2024 is a reassessment year. From now to the end of August, our staff can help you review your home or business assessment. If you would like to discuss your assessment, please give us a call at 225-686-7278 or come by our office on Government Boulevard in Livingston. We're always here to help you.